my friends, and I'm receiving so many sad emails from you. I feel for each of you, and I wish I could help and hug each of you. And I feel so bad when I'm reading your stories, and I don't know why it's happening. I don't know why you have to go through now, but I believe that lots of you will recover, and that's why I'm here trying to support you and to say that you're gonna get better. And as my mom was saying, you know, do not wish to recover for 100%, because it's really, like, you know, hard to reach this goal, but at least try to get better. And then when you will get better, a little bit, just a little bit, then you will have hope, and this hope will take you out. So go for it, go for the, reach for small things, and then you will have bigger things. Yeah, I have a few questions from you again, and I think that's why I'm making videos, because it's much more easier for me to reply in video than to write each of you, because it's really hard and I'm having my own life. But I'm here for you, and we'll try to, again, I'm making a list of questions, and we'll try to reply to you with my bad English. There is the most popular question, which medication I was taking. And yeah, I was taking Cymbalta, and I was taking some Russian neuroleptic, the very old and old-fashioned one, which I'm sure you do not have in this country, in UK. And well, anywhere abroad, because that's really, like, I don't know, maybe a dangerous even one, because with all this health and safety in the country, there is nothing you can buy or be prescribed apart from paracetamol. So and also there was some sedatives, well, same like Xanax, Russian version, but still same. And there was a combo of medication, and I think that the old-fashioned neuroleptic was a very important ingredient in this combo, because it helped me a lot to overcome this dream state. Not completely, but I felt less dreamy after probably a month and a half. And also all this combo helped me to feel my body, to get my body back, and to have more connection with my personality. I started to recognize myself much more, and I think I came half of a way with the medication. But I had to take it for probably a year or a little bit longer. And yeah, when you're asking me, is the mindset the only thing that helped me? No. No. I couldn't cope with my anxiety myself for half a year, and my tryings only brought me to the worst point, because I couldn't cope with the condition. And yeah, this medication helped me a lot. So if you feel that you can't do it yourself, then better go for medication and try it. And also, if most of you saying that, like, the medication didn't help me, it gave me very bad symptoms. I also had very bad experience with the medication, because I tried citalopram, which didn't help me at all, made me very suicidal, and I couldn't take it for even for 2 weeks, because I was going mad and had very bad side effects. So just try different ones which you can have. How to make a plan for recovery? Well, that's very easy. I mean, like, whatever you read in articles, in books, and when you actually, whatever you take into consideration from any others, from other stories. So just make the list of things which you find helpful, and yeah, try to follow them. Whatever is it, like taking supplements or taking medication along with the supplements, doing sport, and finding friends, girlfriend, boyfriend, go for a walk, occupy yourself, change mindset, whatever, everything you can include into your plan, how to recover. try to do that and follow it. But the main point is to be consistent, and consistency is a very important thing. It's not like you do it for a week or for 2 weeks and then you're losing hope. You will have moments when you will lose hope on the way to recovery, but you have next day you have to try again and again and again. And yeah, that's the main thing. Just go for it and make the list and follow it, but follow it every day. Don't think like it didn't help you for 2 weeks. It's not a 2 weeks thing. That for some of us it's gonna be a long journey, so be prepared. And the only thing you have to think about that you're gonna come out, and if you're gonna think this way, you will be closer to it day by day. But don't forget that, you know, it's not only the mindset. Mindset is very important. If you really, I know some people who could cope with this condition, and they didn't have to take any medication. But for some of you who have it for a long time, you definitely have to try everything to stop this anxiety thing, apart from just the mindset. But mindset, right, I don't think you have a right mindset as well if you have it for so long. Do you consider DP as a positive thing? No. No, it's not a spiritual thing, nothing positive. It's like you're just broken, your neurotransmitter doesn't transmit the information in a proper right way. So your brain is malfunctioning, my brain was malfunctioning. So it's definitely not the spiritual thing. It's just a broken mechanism which you need to mend. So yeah, just, yeah. No, that's just funny. As a positive thing, yeah, it can be a positive thing, by the way. If you break your arm or you break your leg, that's a lesson, right? That's a positive thing. So next time you will be more aware of everything around you and more concentrate on, like, where you go. So it is same with DP. So next time you will be less anxious. You will be... you will try to keep your emotions and reactions under control, because you know that it can lead you to the state which you don't want anymore. So, or, yeah, you just have to be more careful. So that's kind of a positive thing about it. So you just know, you just have this experience. And for people like me who came out, I know that every time I'm trying to be anxious about something, or I'm going to become angry like Hulk, I know I have to keep it. And the only reason why I give this reaction, just because my nervous system doesn't work the right way. And that's it. And it's still not recovered 100%. That's why I'm getting angry so much with the small things and give this bad reaction to tiny moments. And that's the positive thing. Now I know that I can be broken. And I have to keep it under control. Also, you was asking me about that before. Do I drink and do I smoke weed? No, I do not do anything like that. I was drinking and smoking. I was a heavy smoker. I was like occasional drinker, but I'm not doing that anymore because, as I said, when I stopped, my recovery was much faster. And the only reason why, you understand, because it's influencing the nervous system, the brain and everything. So yeah, just stop. If you do that, stop it. And well, I'm very surprised when people saying they were smoking weed, they got this condition and they still trying to do that because they think it will take them out. That's really silly. But if you want to do that, you know, go for it, you know, have fun. Books. The real good book, the only real good book which I've read was by Paul David. It's called At Last Alive. That's the best thing I've ever read, and it really did magic to me, because every time I was in a very bad mode, very bad state, the worst state in my DP story, this book was giving me so much hope. And every time I read it, like I've never read it before, and really believe, truly believe that I can come out. So that's the book about exactly the depersonalization, which actually includes so many stories of some other people as well. and you know many tips and everything. I'm sure you know it all, but still, that's a really good book, and I advise it a lot. I also had this one, Anxiety Rebalance, written by Carl Vernon. This one. It's not about depersonalization. It does have a small chapter about it, but also about the guy who had very bad anxiety. And that's a very positive book. It also helped me, and I was really enjoying reading it. And I think the moment when you understand that the main thing is not treating depersonalization but treating anxiety, then you will be you will find some real informative things in this in this kind of books. But you know, when you're buying stuff exactly about depersonalization, there is no point to waste your money. There is nothing about depersonalization. It's only about the heavy anxiety, crazy anxiety which you're having, and that's why you have this condition. Also, how much time it takes to overcome. Hard to say, because to overcome this condition, you know, I think the recovery was very long, and probably it started when I even didn't notice it. But I would say that I count my recovery since I probably came off the pills, and it happened in the beginning of this year. So I came off completely off pills, and that was the moment when I was coping with the whole thing myself, and day by day it was getting better and better and better. And yeah, I was taking some supplements like 5-HTP and magnesium, everything that can support my nervous system. But that's it. So yeah, I would say the moment of real recovery took around like 6 months for me. But I think it started earlier, with the moments of going backwards and some good days or bad days. But as I said to one person recently, these bad days and good days started for me probably in the beginning of recovery, which was unnoticeable, because before medication, every day was bad, and each day was worse and worse and worse. So when you have good days and bad days, it means like you're not in that bad state, or you're obviously getting better. What is the cure? I already told you about the cure is a combo of everything, of following the you know, right mindsets, and trying to stay positive and hopeful, and trying to live your life, and taking medication to calm down, and trying to control everything, trying to control your feelings, your emotions, your fears, trying to explain to yourself all your fears and stop being scared of it with the time. So that's the cure. That's the cure. The only cure is stop being scared. Because I think you know it already. When you're not so stressed out, then you give yourself a chance to recover. Did my symptoms disappear gradually? Yes, it did. It did. It was very gradual, so sometimes even unnoticeable. But with the time, it was better and better. So there were moments when I actually felt like, wow, it's gone. Like, there was a moment when I stopped to understand who I am, and I understood that this feeling of not knowing who I am is gone. So it felt like in a proper way. But it didn't happen in one day. So there was like gradual thing, and I was understanding more and more and more. And also the question about the religion, can it help? Yeah, it can help. Everything which gives you the hope can help. So I was myself also in church a few times, praying and crying. Sometimes I thought that God doesn't exist, or he just hates me so much that he gave me this condition and doesn't help me. But no, don't think this way, and don't get angry. Use it as a hope. Use it as someone powerful who can give you recovery, but not give you as a present. You have to earn it. Like, there is a religious song, like it sounds like, Lord, don't move that mountain, but give me strength to climb it. So it's the same way. Like, you have to fight for it. God never gives you presents, he gives you challenge. So that's your challenge, and he will be next to you, he will help you, but you have to do it yourself.